most people don't know right away when they've been infected with HIV infection. This is because the signs and symptoms of primary HIV may be similar to other common illnesses. Early detection of symptoms, testing for HIV, and initiating antiretroviral therapy as soon as possible can all help to reduce the risk of transmission to another person. In this video, we'll look at early signs and symptoms of HIV infection. Fever is typically one of the earliest signs of HIV. Fever is described as an increase in body temperature above normal, which is often accompanied by sweating, chills, and shivering. Fever usually occurs within 2 to 4 weeks of exposure to the virus. At this point, the virus in your body is beginning to multiply in massive quantities. As a result, your immune system triggers an inflammatory response, resulting in fever. Lymphadenopathy, which refers to the enlargement of lymph nodes, is common in people with human immunodeficiency virus, and it is one of the earliest signs of HIV infection. Lymph nodes are part of the immune system and help to fight infection by removing bacteria and viruses. When you get an infection, they become swollen as shown in the image to the right. In people with HIV, lymphadenopathy most commonly develops on either side of the neck, under the jaw, and the armpits or the groin. They can result in aches and pains in these areas. Although lymphadenopathy can occur for many viral infections, HIV infections is suspected when the nodes are greater than 2 centimeters in diameter and last longer than 3 months, a condition referred to as persistent generalized lymphadenopathy. One of the symptoms of acute HIV infection is night sweats. This kind of sweating is really heavy sweating where people will find that their sheets are soaked in sweat when they wake up. Excessive sweating can be accompanied by fever or chills, but these symptoms aren't usually noticeable. Many people do sweat at night, especially if their bedroom is heated or if they sleep with too many blankets. Slight dampness of your sheets is normal and doesn't indicate night sweats. However, when there are repeated episodes of very heavy sweating during sleep, heavy enough to soak your sheets, that is defined as night sweats. Hormonal changes, cancer, various systemic diseases, and other factors, as well as HIV, can cause night sweats. It is very important to get tested early to find out whether you have HIV to allow you to start treatment before the virus causes severe symptoms. Headaches can range in severity from moderate to severe, and they might feel like intense pressure, tightness, or throbbing. HIV itself and opportunistic diseases are all potential causes of HIV-related headaches. Patients might as well feel tired and lethargic as a result of the immune system's inflammatory reaction. Early diagnosis and treatment of headaches are critical because they can improve the quality of life and, depending on the diagnosis, prolong survival. One of the most common complications of HIV is diarrhea. It might be severe or mild, resulting in loose stools on occasion. Diarrhea normally disappears within a few days. However, diarrhea can become chronic and severe in HIV patients. It can also result in health issues. Diarrhea that isn't addressed is very dangerous and can cause dehydration or other potentially fatal problems. Treatment significantly reduces the incidence of gastrointestinal opportunistic infections, lowering the risk of infectious diarrhea. A dry cough, sore throat, and other symptoms affecting the lungs and respiratory system are possible complications of HIV. A persistent, dry cough that persists for weeks to months despite medications is a common symptom in HIV patients who are very sick. HIV lowers the body's ability to fight infection and other diseases, which can lead to a dry cough. It is important to note that a dry cough is a common complaint and does not necessarily mean you've contracted the virus. Any person with persistent symptoms such as these should see a doctor, especially if symptoms are worsening. Skin rashes can occur early after infection and can last between 2 to 3 weeks. It can be itchy, red or purple, or painful. The rash happens when your body tries to fight off the virus. In some cases, the skin rashes look like boils that are itchy with pink breakouts. Many people are unaware that these symptoms might mimic other common illnesses such as the flu or an allergic reaction and disappear rapidly. It's necessary to get tested as soon as possible if you believe you've been exposed to HIV or have an active sex life, regardless of whether you're showing symptoms of HIV or not. And that's all for this video. Thank you for watching. We hope that you found this information helpful and informative. Remember, HIV is a serious but manageable condition, and there are many resources available to help those living with HIV live healthy and fulfilling lives. If you have any questions or concerns about HIV, we encourage you to talk to a healthcare provider or reach out to a trusted organization that specializes in HIV education and support. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more informative content.